big ass meat. Okay, class, thank God today is Friday. Happy Friday. We're going to continue where we ended last time. Okay, talking about a reservoir. A reservoir is a place where this bacteria lives and multiply. For example, the intestine of a poultry and cattle. Young animals are more likely to have them. Intestinal tract of warm-blooded animals in wildlife reservoir like wild birds, such as ducks, geese, and seagulls. Other domestic birds and insects can also house this bacteria in their exoskeleton. Let's talk about transmission to the host.
Excuse me, I can't hear you.
I'll move forward, please. Visiting a farm, contact with dogs and cats that have diarrhea. Contaminated diseases on fruit and vegetable only from the soil. Consumption of raw milk, handling of raw poultry or eat raw poultry or drink untreated water. Excuse me, please. Class, I'm sorry, I'm having an emergency. We're gonna stop here for today, and we'll continue on Monday. You have a happy weekend.
Hello, sir. How may I help you today?
I am doing good. I'm trying to be good, doctor. I got a problem, that's why I'm here.
All right, what's your problem today?
2 days ago, Doc, I went hunting down across the street, you know, and I got this big ass buffalo. And I got this good chunk of meat from it. And I drank some water from the stream, it was good and fresh. And then after that, I started feeling my body. Like, for instance, I'm having like high fever. And whenever I eat something, it just like it comes out fast, like watery stool, and with some blood in it, Doc. That's what I'm here.
All right. So I think I have an idea of what you have, and I think I'm gonna have my lab assistant come in and help you. Okay.
Okay, doctor.
Hi, I'm Macy. I'm the lab assistant.
Okay.
I'm gonna take your stool sample and isolate the bacteria in it.
My stool sample.
Yeah, so you're gonna go to the bathroom and I'll get a sample. And so basically I'm going to perform a series of tests and see what comes back positive. I'll run this and be right back.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so your stool sample came back positive for Campylobacter jejuni, and the doctor will explain more and answer any questions that you have.
Campylobacter jejuni?
Yes, she's going to explain it. Jejuni. Yep.
Thank you.
All right. So Campylobacter jejuni is a bacteria that is curved or spiraled in shape. It moves around with either unipolar or bipolar flagella, and it survives best in 42 degrees Celsius. Campylobacter jejuni usually enters the body through raw food contaminated with this bacteria. With the help of this flagella and an addition of the biofilm, it is specifically attached to the cells of your internal mucosa. This bacteria can survive in aerobic environments and can cope with the stress of low oxygen. The bacteria also produces cytotoxins, which is why you have diarrhea right now. You have to be very careful as these drugs These little cells can infect and migrate to your lymphatic system and other parts of your body, causing diseases. The way this bacteria gets from one host to another is through cross-contamination. This is possibly what happens when the slaughtering of animals gets into the meat that people eat. And it can be transferred from animal feces and get into the soil, and then we eat these fruits and vegetables. The way we can treat this bacteria is if we give you azithromycin, which you can take 500 milligrams for 3 days.
Azithromycin?
Yes, azithromycin, sir. And since this bacteria is resistant to fluoroquinolones, this drug will be the best choice for treatment against Campylobacter jejunum. In the future, to prevent from getting this bacteria, I would recommend to avoid cross-contamination between foods. Make sure your fruits and vegetables are cleaned and cooked in correct temperatures, and make sure you don't drink water that is untreated.
Okay, thank you very much, doctor.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank
I hope you feel better, sir.
My pleasure, doctor.
Yes, thank you.
Guys. Cut it up.
For Campylobacter jejuni.
For what?
Stop. You know how do you-